Hey there, it's Amelia, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a graphic in Canva using a template and how to apply edits quickly and easily to customize your graphic. And before I begin, if you find this video helpful, remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Let's get started. I'll click Create a Design. And when you do that, the first thing you'll need to do is select what type of graphic. Let's go ahead and select Instagram post, and you'll see that it will open up a second tab on your laptop if you're using your computer. Okay, and as far as naming the graphic, it will have untitled design Instagram post because that's the category. So the first thing you want to do is just click in here and just type the name for your graphic. And next, on the left, you have a variety of choices of templates, and then you can also add all these different elements and photos and text, etc. So let's just scroll down and give a look. Okay, how about this graphic? Okay, so now that I've selected the template, you could see it on the right. And as I hover over the different objects, you can see what is selectable. Sometimes you have to ungroup things. So for instance, if I click here, you can see that these two objects are grouped. So I'm just going to right click here and click ungroup. And this would allow me to just click on the individual objects so that it's easier to maneuver them and delete or add, etc. So let me just change this. Maybe I want to change the text here. And you know, it's similar to any text in any other app that you edit. Just click to type the text or select and then replace. Maybe this graphic is one that I don't like that I want to replace. I'm going to just hit the delete button on there. And I want to add a new graphic there. So now there's a difference between photos and elements. Photos would be actual photographic pictures, and you can search, like for instance, if you wanted to just type in flowers or sale, something like that. Now elements are pretty much illustrations, and you can also search for those as well. And this includes shapes, different stickers, and if you're looking for something static that is not moving, just go to this icon here for the filters and just click static, you know, versus animated. And if you're only using the free Canva, then you might want to check here for free. This way you won't be tempted. Now, what you'll notice is a little crown symbol on some of the graphics or other elements, and that would mean that it's not free, and then there would be one that you'd have to purchase. So let me go ahead and click apply filters here, and I'm just going to search for flowers again. Okay, and perhaps I want to scroll down and just pick something like for spring. I'm just going to click here. Now you could either click on it and then drag it, or let me just undo that with Control Z, or let's pick something else. You can also drag it like this, and that will just save you a step. Now perhaps I like that, but I want to change it up a little bit. Grab the handles to resize, drag it with your four-headed arrow. You're going to see this vertical line here appear, which is helping you center the graphic within that particular shape. Move that down, and you can also take advantage of some of the features here, bold, italics, underline for text, depending on the font, the alignment. There's also lists and spacing and other effects. So I left this graphic here. Let me just click on it and hit delete. The springtime sale is nice, but it's a little light. So I think I want to change that to a different color. So with that image selected here, click on text color. And then let's change that to something brighter. That looks much better. Maybe I want to change this to black. So I'm going to select all by triple clicking, or you can use Control A. And I want to change that text color to black. And this down here, definitely cannot see the text at all. This again is grouped together, so I'm going to right click and select ungroup. Remove this graphic here, select it and press delete. You can also right click and select delete. And if I want to select all the text inside, just make sure you click inside, select all the text here. Again, I'm just going to use Control A. And I want to increase the font size by clicking the plus sign here. Let's try to select a number. There we go. Actually, I find it easier to just use the drop down. Let's go ahead and use 36 and drag that up. Maybe change the date. And again, this is really hard to see, so I'm going to change the text color. And this one, website, is just going to put in here, 123 store.com. Okay, so let's select all the text, change that to a darker color, and perhaps I want to italicize it. And to do that, I'm going to change to a different font. Let's pick this one here. And now I can italicize it and make it just a little bit smaller so everything will fit. Okay, it just gives you an example of how easy it is to edit and quickly create your own graphic. You can also use some of the additional features here. Add notes, you can duplicate the page, you can add a second page if you like. You can also add a page down in here. Now it's set for 51% zoom, but let's change that to 75. That might make it easier to work in. Now that I look at this, it's a little bit dark, so I'm gonna select that and go with a different colored font. Let's pick this here. Alrighty, and then there's also, if you wanna look at it in full screen, just takes a moment, and then just press escape or click here to exit full screen, return back. And now let's say you're all finished and you want to download that as a graphic that you can post on your social media. Click share, then click download. And ping's good if you have something where you want a transparent background, but in this case, I'm just going to go with JPEG, small file size. And this is fine, quality's at 80, perfect, and I'll click download. And then it will proceed with downloading. It will download into your downloads folder, or if you're on your mobile device, it will download into your pictures, and it's ready for you to use and post on your social media. Just click X when finished, and since this was in a second tab, I'll just go ahead and close the tab. And we'll return back to the Canva homepage. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and smash the like button and remember to subscribe so you don't miss any new videos. Bye now.